Testing, testing.
Hey, how are you, Sheriff? Pleasure to meet you. So good. Makes
sense. Okay.
Hi, my name is Chelsea Youngman, and I am a counsel with First Liberty Institute, and we are here today for Judge Mack's press conference with Attorney General Ken Paxton, who will be announcing very important information about the lawsuit today. Judge Mack had a lawsuit filed against him for his chaplaincy program and stay tuned with us for a minute because we're about to go live.
Well, thank you for everybody for coming. My name is Hiram Sasser. I'm one of the lawyers for First Liberty Institute, and we're representing Judge Mack. We appreciate you coming. We're going to start off first with Attorney General Ken Paxton.
Thank you all for coming this afternoon. Today, my office, on behalf of the Texas Commission, you can't hear me? What are you saying? I'm law enforcement, filed a motion to intervene in a lawsuit in order to support Montgomery Justice of the Peace Wayne Mack's tradition of courtroom prayer. Last August, in response to a request from the Lieutenant Governor, I issued an opinion that Judge Mack's courtroom prayer follows the model U.S. Supreme Court upheld in the town of Greece versus Galloway. In fact, America's judiciary since the founding has opened the court with prayer. Judges today should be able to do the same. Judge Mack's practices are part of the rich history of judicial prayer in this country. He created a volunteer chaplaincy program to assist him, followed by law enforcement, to adapt. The volunteers come from all faiths and all religions. They also provide prayer at the beginning of the judge's courtroom proceedings. It's amazing that in a country founded on religious liberty, the centuries-old practice of judicial and public bodies focusing on prayer is coming under attack. Just because the Freedom from Religion Foundation claims it is offended by hearing public prayer does not mean that the prayer has to be silenced. Public officials throughout Texas need to be encouraged. We're here to do that. Judge Mack's courtroom prayer is lawful, constitutional, and embodies religious expression. One of the core principles of our nation is self-government. As Attorney General, I will always uphold my constitutional duty to preserve, protect, and defend the religious freedom of every citizen.
And next, we're going to have Kyle Hawkins from the law firm of Gibson, Dunn & Crutcher, who is also one of the other attorneys for Judge Mack.
It's a great honor to be here today representing Judge Mack. Since the founding of the Republic, courts across this country have opened their proceedings with an invocation that is inclusive and voluntary. Judge Mack's practice fits fully into that long-standing history and tradition. And the Supreme Court has repeatedly upheld invocations just like those that Judge Mack permits. Complying with the law is crucial. And that's why we have to dismiss this lawsuit to the prejudice. On behalf of my client, I would like to thank General Paxton for his leadership and support.
Next, we'll hear from Judge Mack.
Thank you all for being here. Several years ago, I started the volunteer chaplaincy program of all religious faiths in our community. And I began this program because I found it difficult to perform my duties as the Justice of the Peace. That also includes me being the county coroner. And this interfaith volunteer chaplains, this program, they arrive at all hours of the day and night and give their time and talent and resources, and they help me to be able to conduct my independent investigation and tend to the needs of the victims and the families that are on that location. I'm honored to thank the volunteer chaplains of all faiths to open our court proceedings with a brief invocation. I modeled this courtroom invocation after the Texas Supreme Court, the U.S. Supreme Court, and many other government bodies. After receiving feedback from the State Commission on Judicial Conduct and the Attorney General Paxton's opinion, I decided to continue my courtroom practice in accordance with the law, and now I hope again to win in court. Thank you.
As you can see, this case is about history and tradition. This is an opening court proceedings with an evocation. It's something that's been going on in this country for two centuries. And just recently, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled that a chaplain program opening government bodies of prayer is perfectly constitutional. And I think you can see from the type of variety and diversity of experience and backgrounds that are reflected in the chaplaincy program that this is a positive program and certainly should be upheld. With that, does anyone have any questions? All right, well, thank you guys so much. We appreciate you guys coming out. Thank you very much.